السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Blessings to all of you. Not all of us can have the same path. Actually, everyone has a different one. But you can follow, we can follow the truth. In this we are common. The truth unites us. If we have the intention for truth, even the factive truth, but more than that, the higher truth, the inner truth, if we have that intention, we will become a humanity, we will become a collective, we will become healthy. If we do not have that, we will not reach there. So, this is why the next time is called in the Eastern tradition Sat Yoga, which means it is the time of truth. In other traditions, it is called the age of balance, of harmony. And in some other traditions, it is called the golden age. Yeah. So more or less, they express the same in different words. And we have to see only ourselves. This is the duty we have. We have to respond to ourselves and to see our mistakes and to see our lies, to see our misbehaviors and to try to correct them. That's all. And when you are belonging to this kind of group, that you want to be a straight person and you want to be a person who is ready to see their own mistakes and to take responsibility, then you will experience a shift within you. And that means you will be not as touched from any kind of situation which happens on the surface in this planet. You will not be touched in the same way, not emotionally, not mentally, not physically. And this is a secret that cannot be explained. It's a mystery. Yeah? And it has been appearing in many stories in our tradition, the Sufi tradition. There have been many stories told that people who were protected in very, very, very strong crises, in apocalyptic situations, they were protected. Yeah. And this will always be. There will be always people who will be protected. And they are protected not because they are rich, or because they are strong, or because they are smart. No. They are protected because they have a love. At the end, the only thing which really protects us is not strength, it's not power, it's not military this or that. What protects us is love. And when we come to love for the one who loves us, for the being or for the isness, it is so difficult to describe it. But there is a love around. And that love loves us, that love speaks to us, that love addresses us, that love cares for us. So when you fall in love with that love, yeah, you will also find yourself protected. And that should be your faith. So faith is the road to love. Faith is the road to truth, to be in balance. And to reach there, we have to surrender. There is no other way. We have to surrender what is not truth. We have to surrender what is not love. We have to surrender what is not correct, what is not pure, what is not straight. So everything what we have now, we actually have to surrender it. Because you can see we're living in dirt. We're living in a dirty environment. Not only on the level of earth, of the pollution of the earth, that is one. But we are living in a very dirty level of what happens on earth, what we do to the weakest, how we treat each other. We are on a very, very dirty and low level. So do not think that we will be protected there. No. Some will be. Most no. Unless they do not repent and they turn around, it will not happen. And you can think this is a kind of blind belief or blind doctrine or whatever that is, whatever you want to call it. No. The rules, they apply anywhere you will be born, in any dimension you will come. Never you will be able to escape from truth. And nowhere you will find a place where the love is not on you. When you realize that, you can stay calm in the middle of the storm. And remember the story of Jesus when he was in the boat and they were in a storm, him and his disciples. And the boat on top of that had a kind of leakage and the water came and the storm was tremendous. And they saw Jesus calm. He was totally calm in the middle of the storm. And they asked him, how can you be so calm? And he said, how can you have so little faith? Don't lose your faith. Don't lose your faith. Whatever there is, whatever in the movie happens, don't lose your faith. There will be a happy end because the source is happy. The source is bliss. The source is love. So there will be a love end. There will be a happy end. But the end, what the end means, this is in the secret of the divine. So we all end individually in our described time. So the end is not collective. It is only individual. If you have an individual end, make sure it's a happy end. And my master used to say, you have to train only for one moment. And this is the moment of your death. Make sure that you live the life that when death comes to you, and death comes to you with judgment, because it's Saturn, it comes to you with judgment. It is the moment where you have to face yourself and where everything is unveiled. Even you try to veil it all your life from yourself, it will be unveiled that moment. So he said, make sure that you unveiled as much as possible and that you took responsibility, that you could forgive as much as possible. And that you have faith. Keep faith. If you want to do something good, be friendly with those who need help, especially to the children, especially to the weak ones, to the elder ones, to those who cannot take care for themselves. And we are heading now in Ramadan. Ramadan is the holy month, it's the month of humanity. And in this month, we try to exercise, to practice, especially what it means to be together. So we share our food, but we are fasting. That is a very big point, we are fasting. And fasting means we are not only fast from food or sexual activities, we fast from, for example, shopping. We fast from consuming unnecessary things. We are fasting, fasting, fasting. We are fasting from backbiting. We are fasting from being fearful. All these things are very easy in Ramadan to do. This is the magic of this month. So you may not be a Muslim, you may not consider yourself as a religious person, that's all right. But you may try to fast because it has to do with the moon. And you do not have to believe in the moon because the moon is in front of us. For example, this moon is a very strong moon, very, very strong moon that we are now going to experience. And tomorrow night there will be a special night, it's the night of destination. So for those of you who are not in this tradition, it is still a night which will count very strong, and you should try to stay awake. If you can pray in your way, if you can be silent in your way, if you can be inward in the way you know, that will be very, very, very beneficial. So we wish you a very happy night, and you are the smith, the goldsmith of your own life. This you have to understand. So take this power and act. Act in your life. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Blessings to all of you.
Bismillah.